Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another one of my guitar lessons. This time we are going to be discussing how to build three-note guitar harmonies. This was a question that was sent in from Ken. He's out in Kula, Hawaii, and he wrote in saying, I like the sounds of having multiple guitar parts played in a harmony. I understand how to make a two-part harmony with one melody getting another interval on it, mostly just by thirds, but I'd like to know how things could work if there were three parts. Could you make a lesson covering how three guitar parts could be performed together, harmonized? From Ken in Kula, Hawaii, USA. Well, thanks for writing in, Ken. You know, when we layer three parts together, we have the opportunity for a really rich sound, and this could occur in a few different ways. One idea is through simply stacking the triad tones, and this would involve the root, third, and the fifth of each melody tone as we would relate them to the key signature. Another way to do this is to expand upon an existing harmony and take the tones out further from perhaps the fifth, you know, maybe going up through the seventh and then through extensions like the ninth and so on. And another idea for doing this work would be to create layers of different linear melodies that operate against a foundational line and remain within the key signature, but yet do not follow one particular interval across each of the melody tones. And this is, of course, more complex, but with some basic tips and some help through this video, you should be able to have some success getting started with it. So let's not waste any time and get going on building some different three-note harmony layers to learn this idea from. Well, in getting set up for creating our work with three-note harmony, we're going to prepare for the upcoming examples by establishing the key that we're going to be working within. I'll play through the foundational melody that I composed for our three-note harmony exercises, and we'll organize our first three-note harmony around the structure of root, third, and fifth intervals from a triad. So we're going to stay diatonic to the key. The key is going to be the key of B minor. And I want to start off by just playing the diatonic melody for you. It sounds like this. So that's a melody in B minor covering B minor chord. Going to E minor, A, back to B. Right, here it is one more time for you. I'm going to play it through with the loop pedal going, and then what I'm going to do is we'll start talking through on what happens when you start establishing your three-note triad harmony. Here we go. All All right, so that's going to be in the looper now. We're going to move on next to establishing our first three-note triad harmony that's diatonic to our key center here of B minor. Now, the idea of creating this format, a harmony, rests upon organizing the diatonic intervals from each tone of the melody line. As we go through that melody, each of those notes, we're going to do them as thirds, and then we're going to do them as fifths. And in the first measure of the foundational melody, we're going to begin with the notes of G, F sharp, E, then D. And if we travel a third from each of these scale tones, we're going to wind up getting B, A, G, and F sharp. Then what you do is you continue across the other melody tones in the same way, and that sets you up with building a two-note harmony. So I'm going to hit the looper pedal. We're going to listen to those to the example one melody go by, and then I'm going to jump on this second layer of harmony and play that against it. So first of all, here's the looper playing the example number one melody. Now, to construct the third melodic layer, we simply travel a fifth from each scale tone of our foundational melody. Off of those same initial tones of the foundational line, we would end up in the new third melodic line with the notes of now going D, C sharp, B, and A. So those are the fifths coming from the G, F sharp, E, and the D. So I'm going to come back in a second after programming the loop pedal with the thirds ideas, and I'm going to play the fifths ideas on top of that. Well, in applying yet another approach on working with three-note harmonies, I wanted to take a look at building extended lines from the intervals of already existing tones. What I'll be doing in this case is taking the line used back in example two, which was built from fifth intervals of our example one foundational melody. We'll start with the fifth intervals line as shown in your handout as example three. Here's how it sounds on its own. Now I'm going to place that into the loop pedal, and then we're going to work out some other stuff on top of it. All right, next what we're going to do is build new intervals to function as a new three-note harmony related back to our original melody line based upon example one. Now, this concept can work really well for engaging a brand new sound from an already existing section of a piece of music. And in example four, I'll be applying intervals that operate as both sevenths and ninths. So here's how we'll do this. Our main analytical line of thought will still be that foundational melody. You can find that in your handout as example one. But the fifths melody from example three will be our new lower range idea that we're in bass going further off of for the new lines, with the second layer of harmony actually coming from an interval distance of sevenths, and the third level of harmony that we'll do afterward will be constructed from ninths. So let's just get started with hearing how the fifths and the seventh intervals sound against each other. So remember, the fifths are in the loop pedal, and then I'm going to be playing the sevenths above that. So first of all, I'm going to fire the loop pedal up, we'll get that going, and then I'll come in over top with the sevenths.
Thank you.
right. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to layer the sevenths on top of those fifths and then come back, and I'm going to play the ninth intervals on top of that yet. Well, in my final example, I wanted to run through one of the more complex forms of creating three-note harmony ideas. This concept involves the use of different, separate melodies which are interacting along with one another, all using scale tones diatonic to one key signature. Now, these supplemental melodies will function alongside of an original melodic statement, all the while still being in harmony. However, they will not consistently be following any established interval design coordinated alongside of the foundational part. Now, to demonstrate this, I'll take our original foundational melody from back in example one. We're going to use it to build a melodic variation above the line. And for review, here's that original example one melody played on its own once more. It's in your handout, printed again as example number five. It goes like this. All right, for building the new layers, we'll want to keep a few things in mind. First of all, using the diatonic scale tones of the key signature will be fairly important in the beginning, but I should also mention that, you know, in jazz and fusion and progressive rock and some other styles, intervals could be applied that are non-diatonic, but for our examples, we'll remain within the key. We're all going to be functioning here within B minor. Another important idea will be rhythmic pushes, you know, in areas where the original melody accents either a downbeat or an upbeat. We'll want to tie in with those rhythmic accents. You know, if we don't, the end result of the three-note harmony will be kind of broken sounding or off-center in those particular areas. So what we're going to do is start with the second layer that I've come up with, and it's a real simple line. It sounds like this on its own. So you can hear it's really on the off beats there, on the ands of four and the and of two and so on. So what I'm going to do is, in the loop pedal, I've got that original melody from example one, it's still programmed in there. So I'm going to fire that up, and then I'm going to play this second layer on top of that. Here we go. All right, now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to spend a moment, record the example six part that we just went through there, and then I'm going to layer another idea on top of that for a third part as well. So let me come back in a moment and we'll get that going. Creating three-note layered harmonies will involve not only a knowledge of intervals, but also of key signatures and voicings. When applied together in a conventional sense, let's say as triads, they can sound great in almost any musical situation. Stretching the harmonies out to extensions can often push a melody a little outside the comfort zone for a lot of pieces of music, but it can still be a very cool sound in many different musical styles. Now, one of the more challenging areas for composing these harmonies will mostly be when you're developing separate linear melodies that complement the original melody line. However, one thing to keep in mind is that with any of these concepts, even if your music theory is weak, trial and error will still be one method that you can count on to invent a lot of your own three-note layered harmony ideas. Anyway, that's all for now. Once again, thanks for watching. Have fun working on all these ideas. You can download the handout and the MP3 jam track for this video video over at my website at andrewwasson.com. You can follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook, and subscribe to my other guitar blog, YouTube channel. You definitely want to check out the Sunday release video on that channel. And also, we've got the micro lessons there Monday to Thursday. People really like those, so definitely check those out as well. The links for all this stuff is in the description box. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.